ഹലോ ചിൽഡ്രൻ, വെൽക്കം ബാക്ക് ടു സോഷ്യൽ സയൻസ് ക്ലാസ്. ഇൻ ദ പ്രീവിയസ് ക്ലാസ് വി ഡിസ്കസ് അബൌട്ട് ദ സെക്കൻഡ് ചാപ്റ്റർ ഓഫ് ജിയോഗ്രഫി, ദ സിഗ്നേച്ചർ ഓഫ് ടൈം. സോ വട്ട് ആർ ദ ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻ്റ് കോൺസെപ്റ്റ്സ് വി ലേൺ ഇൻ ദാറ്റ് ചാപ്റ്റർ? ലെറ്റ്സ് ലിസൺ ടു ദ പ്രസൻറ്റേഷൻ. ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻ്റ് ടോപ്പിക്സ് വി ഡിസ്കസ് ഇൻ ദ ലാസ്റ്റ് ക്ലാസ്.
Hi all, I am Gauri Nandan. Now let's recall the things that we have learned in our previous classes from the chapter The Signature of Time. We learned that the earthquakes are frequent in certain parts of the earth. Volcanoes are more common in certain specific regions. There are some peculiarities in the distribution of mountains. The earthquake zones and the distribution of mountains on the earth's surface more or less coincide. We know that the portions of the lithosphere which are several thousand kilometers wide and roughly 100 kilometers thick are called lithospheric plates. There are two types of lithospheric plates, the major plates and the minor plates. There are seven major plates. Among them, the Pacific plate is the largest one. The Pacific plates involve the oceanic parts alone. After that, we discussed about the movement of the plates. Magma, a part of the mantle, remains molten due to high temperature in the Earth's interior. As a result, continuous convection occurs, which leads to the movement of the lithospheric plates. We also discussed about the speed of the movement of plates. The lithospheric plates move around 2 cm to 12 cm a year, which is not always been uniform. After that, we discussed about the types of movement of lithospheric plates. There are mainly three types of movement of lithospheric plates. The convergent margins in which the plates come near each other, the divergent margins in which plates move away from each other, and the transform margins in which plates slide past each other. Four mountains are formed as a result of the convergent margins. For example, the Himalaya is a fold mountain range formed between the Indian plate and the Eurasian plate. The denser plate will submerge under the lighter plate if there is any density difference in between the converged plates. These zones are called the subduction zones. For example, the Challenger Deep in Pacific Ocean. The magma comes out from the gap formed by the divergence of plates and solidifies to form mountains. These type of mountains are called the mid-oceanic ridges. For example, the mid-Atlantic ridge. The fault zones are formed as a result of the transform margins. The San Andreas fault zone in North America is an example for this. Now let's check upon the activities given by the social science teacher in our previous class. The first activity was to classify the plates into two, the major plates and the minor plates. As we see here, the major plates consist of the Pacific plate, the Antarctic plate, the Eurasian plate, the African plate, the Australian plate, the North American plate and the South American plate. And in the case of minor plates consist of the Philippine plates, the Coco plate, the Nazca plate, the Caribbean plate and the Scotian plate. Now let's move on to the second activity. It was to identify the plates which were responsible for the formation of the Challenger Deep. The Challenger Deep is formed as a result of the convergence of the Pacific plate and the Philippine plate. Thank you.
Very good presentation. Thank you. Now we can continue our class with the new concepts. As you know, there are three types of plate margins: divergent margin, convergent margin, and shear margin. The plate margins are generally sensitive to volcanoes and faults. This is because plate margins are weaker than other areas. The major relief features on Earth's surface, such as fold mountains, plateaus and volcanoes, are the result of plate movements. Let's see the other forces that brings about changes on the Earth's surface. Most landforms on the Earth's surface are the result of such earth movements. The earth movements are two types: endogenic movements and exogenic movements. Endogenic movement happens inside the earth, and exogenic movement means that movement happens outside the earth. Endogenic movements again divided into two: diastropic movement and sudden movement. Diastropic movement means slow movement. An example for the diastropic movement is plate movements. And example for sudden movement is volcanic eruption and earthquakes. As a result of the earth movements, some regions on the earth's crust are subjected to upliftment or subsidence. Upliftment means vertical rising movement, and subsidence means downward movement. One of the examples for diastropic movement is plate movement. Plate movements take place at a very slow pace. The effect of slow movement becomes obvious only over a very long period of time. Compared to them, the rapid movement affects the mankind more. Volcanoes and earthquakes come under this category. Dear children, now listen to the stunning experience of Mr. Shering Dorji, a traveler in Nepal.
It was 25th April 2015. I was walking along the streets of Kathmandu with my friend. Suddenly, the huge buildings in front of us began to collapse. The ground beneath us sank like a swing. It was difficult to escape from the shower of bricks and dust from the collapsing buildings. Trenches developed in the road, making it impossible to run away. The hotel complex where we stayed previously had turned into a heap of bricks. I realized that these are the rare moments between life and death. My eyes were witnessing the unbelievable. Within a few minutes, the roads of the city have turned into trenches. Heaps of debris have formed in many parts of the city. The moment I thought I was going to faint, a stranger came through the dust and debris and held me in a tight embrace, smiled at me, and walked away without uttering a word. The smile of suffering and survival.
Children, what you have seen is the unbelievable experience of Mr. Shering Dorji. He has witnessed a deadly earthquake which happened on 25th April 2015. So now let's see in detail what an earthquake is. Rocks in the deeper interior of the earth undergo displacement and fault due to plate movements and other causes. Under such situations, severe pressure is exerted on the Earth's lithosphere and seismic waves are generated, just like waves in a pond spreading in all directions when a heavy object falls into it. These waves create tremors on the Earth's surface. These tremors are experienced by us as earthquake. Apart from plate movements and faulting, earthquakes occur due to other reasons as well. These are collapse of roofs of mines, pressure in reservoirs, volcanic eruptions. Let's see the deep point inside the earth where the earthquake occurs are known as focus, and the point vertically above it on the earth's surface is known as epicenter. So here we learn two terms, focus and epicenter. So focus means it is the starting point of earthquake inside the earth, and the point vertically above the earth's surface is known as epicenter. You have to identify and mark the focus and epicenter in the diagram. Next, you have to watch a small video clip regarding earthquake.
What is an earthquake? It simply means shaking of the earth. It is caused due to release of energy, which generates waves that travel in all directions. You'll have to look at this picture. This is a fault. A fault is a sharp break in the crustal rocks. Rocks near a fault tend to move in opposite directions. That creates friction, but at some point of time, their movements overcome the friction. As a result, they slide past one another. This causes a release of energy, and the energy waves travel in all directions. The point where the energy is released is called the focus of an earthquake, or there is also a term given to it called the hypocenter. the energy waves traveling in different directions reach the surface. The point on the surface nearest to the focus is called epicenter. This place is the first one to experience the waves. All natural earthquakes take place in the lithosphere. The lithosphere refers to the portion of depth up to 200 km from the surface of the earth. An instrument called seismograph records the wave reaching the surface. The waves look something like this. The curve shows three distinct sections, each representing different types of wave patterns.
Now try to answer these questions. Which are the three types of waves produced from the focus during the earthquake? Which type of waves reach the surface of the earth first? Which is the most destructive waves? Yes, very good. Three type of waves are produced from the focus of the earth during an earthquake. Primary waves, secondary waves, and surface waves. The primary waves reach the earth's surface first. And the surface waves are the most destructive ones. How can we record the seismic waves? The seismic waves are recorded by an instrument called seismograph. And do you know how the intensity of the earthquake measured? The scale used for measuring the intensity of earthquake is known as Richter scale.
The Richter scale or Richter magnitude scale was developed in 1935 by Charles F. Richter of the California Institute of Technology as a mathematical device to compare the size of earthquakes. The magnitude of an earthquake is determined from the logarithm of the amplitude of waves recorded by seismograph.
The Richter scale measures the intensity of energy released at the time of an earthquake. The earthquake that occurred in Chile has been the most severe one. It recorded an intensity of 9.5 in the Richter scale. Children, let me ask one question. Can you name the giant waves that hit the Kerala coast on 26 December 2004? Yes, it is the tsunami. Tsunami is a Japanese term meaning harbor waves. Children, now you understand that many a time earthquake occurring on ocean floor cause giant sea waves. Such violent sea waves that rise several meter high are known as tsunamis. What are the measures we can take to mitigate the impact of tsunamis? Recession in sea level may be an indicator of tsunami. If so, move on to safer locations. Always take official warning seriously. Don't arrive at self-conclusion that the dangerous situation is over. Wait for official declaration. Once trapped by tsunami waves, try to escape holding any floating materials firmly. Now we studied the impact of tsunami and how to mitigate the effect of tsunami. Tsunami surveillance and warning systems are widely in operation today. This system aims to identify the areas prone to tsunami and also to extend warning to coastal areas so as to prevent loss of life. On behalf of the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, NOAA, a real-time tsunami monitoring system named DART, Deep Ocean Assessment and Reporting of Tsunami, has been established at various locations. Satellite communication systems are being utilized for this purpose. Now watch the world map and analyze the map using the hints. Plate margins, distribution of volcanoes. Is there any relation between plate margins and distribution of volcanoes? Yes, plate margins are active with volcanoes. Now watch a video of volcanic eruption. From the video, it is clear that volcanoes are formed by molten rock material coming out through the fissures along the plate margins. Nearly 80% of the world's volcanoes are situated around the Pacific Ocean. This zone containing more than 452 volcanoes is known as the Pacific Ring of Fire. Children, you know that volcanoes pose serious threats to life, but they are also useful in many ways. The soil formed by the weathering of lava rock is fertile. Example, the black soil of Deccan Plateau. Volcanic ash is a good manure. Geysers are formed in many volcanic regions. Such regions are being developed as tourist centers. Example, the Old Faithful Geyser, Yellowstone National Park in North America. Dear children, that's all with the second chapter. Before winding up, let's recall the important concept we study in this chapter. Who is going to do that?
The chapter is Signature of Time. And first topic we have discussed is about the earth movements. And there are two types of earth movement: endogenic movement and exogenic movement. And there are two types of endogenic movement: diastrophic movement and sudden movement. And an example for diastrophic movement is plate movement, and an example for sudden movement is earthquake and volcanic eruption. And the next topic we have studied is about the earthquake. And what is an earthquake? Yes, the rocks in the deeper part of the earth undergoes displacement and falls due to plate movement and other causes. Under such situation, several pressure is exerted on the Earth's lithosphere and seismic waves are generated. Such waves create tremors on the Earth's surface, and these tremors are experienced by us as an earthquake. And we also discussed about focus and epicenter. And three types of waves are produced from focus during the time of an earthquake. They are primary wave, secondary wave, and surface wave. And surface wave is the most destructive one. And the instrument used to record seismic waves are called seismograph. And the Richter scale measures the intensity of the energy released at the time of an earthquake. And the next topic we have discussed is about tsunami. Then what is a tsunami? The thermal waves originated due to volcanic eruption, earthquake and meteor impact, etc. in the ocean floor generate huge sea waves rising to several meters. Such sea waves are called tsunamis. And on behalf of National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, NOAA, a real-time tsunami monitoring system named DART, Deep Oceanic Assessment and Reporting of Tsunami, has been established in various locations. And satellite communication system has been utilized for this purpose. And we also studied that what are the measures that we can take to mitigate the impact of tsunami. And the next topic we have discussed is about volcanoes. And how volcanoes are formed? Yes, volcanoes are formed by such molten rock materials rising through fissures along the plate margins. And we also studied about Pacific Ring of Fire. And how volcanoes are useful for man. And this is all from my part, and thank you all.
The presentation was very good. All the details are included in the presentation. After that, here is a small assignment for you. The first one, complete the flowchart based on earth movement. And second one, you have to mark the Pacific Ring of Fire in the given outline map of world. Dear children, I would like to remind one more thing, that you have to read this chapter in detail in your textbook. And also there are some questions given at the end of this chapter. Do answer them. If there is any doubt, please consult with your social science teacher. I wish all the very best to each one of you. Thank you.